Now we come to the carry look-ahead adder. So what is the carry look-ahead adder? Before this, we had seen the ripple carry adder. So ripple carry adder, in each of the full adders, in each of the full adders, before it can start working, before this full adders can start working, it should wait for this carry to come. The full adder here, the full adder that should come here, it should wait for this carry to come in order for this to execute. This full adder must wait for this carry to come in order for this to execute. So this this makes the process more tedious and it takes more gate delays. So to reduce the number of gate delays to do the addition, we have come up with the carry look-ahead adder. In the carry look-ahead adder, what we do is, in that we have to wait for the carry for a long time, in the ripple carry adder. So here, we compute carries for all the full adders in one go, and then we go on to do the sums. We calculate the SIs. So, from before the each of the full adders, SI is XI, XOR, YI, XOR, CI. And CI plus 1 is XI, YI plus XI, CI plus YI, CI. This we had done before. So, with that said, we have to, for doing the carry look-ahead adder, we have two functions, GI and PI. GI is called generate function and PI is called propagate function. So, GI is defined as XI, YI. And PI is defined as XI plus YI. Now, this is the equation that comes out. CI plus 1, any carry CI plus 1 is equal to GI plus PI CI. So, now we'll try to see what each of the carries are. The carries we want to find out is C0, C1, C2 and C3. C0 we already have. C1, C2, C3 and C4 we want to find out. C0 is 0. As a carry in the first bit will also be always be 0. As you can see here, the carry that comes here, it will be 0, right? So C0 we already have. We want to find out the C1, C2, C3 and all, C3 and so on, we need to find out. So that is what we are trying to find out using this equation. So this equation, when we do it for C1, we using that same first equation, we try to find the C1. So C1 is X0, Y0, that is G0, plus X0 plus Y0, C0, that is P0. What is the same equation? CI plus 1 is equal to GI plus PI CI, that is what we have written here. G0 plus P0, C0. So we have C1 is equal to G0 plus P0, C0. Now we write it for C2. C2 also, we write the same equation. Now, instead of the C1, we write whatever is here, we substitute it here, instead of C1. So, what do we get here? G1 plus P1 G0 plus P1 P0 G0. How exactly we get it is like, another way we can write this is, G1 plus P1 C1. Okay. Now C1, what is it? G1 plus P1 into G0 plus P0 C0. Now if you multiply, we'll get G1 plus P1 G0 plus P1 P0 C0. P1 P0 C0. This is C. Okay. P1 P0 C0. That's what you get. Likewise, we can find out for C3. C3 also, we instead of this, what is C3? We find this P, instead of this, if we carry on the same way, we get G2 plus P2 G1 plus P2 P1 G0 plus P2 P1 P0 C0. It is like a series. The same thing we can do for C4, that is G3 plus P3 G2 plus P3 P2 G1 plus P3 P2 P1 G0 plus P3 P2 P1 P0 C0. It is just like a series. You can also get the same equation by using this equation. This equation, you can substitute the values from the previous equations to get the same equation. But it is almost like a series, so you can just find out what is a pattern and then get how you do it. So what have we done here? In here, we have essentially done is, we have gotten all this carries in terms of PIs, GIs and C0s. That means we can, so C0 we already have, GIs and PIs, it is all calculated using XI and YI. All the XIs and YIs we have. So in one gate delay, we will have all the PIs and GIs, and C0 also we can we already have, that is C0 will be 0. So in terms of these three variables, we have written every one of the carries. So this is how the equation looks. When we go into the actual circuit diagram, things will be much more clear. In the next video, we will do the circuit.